Now we'll move on to converters. These are where the catalytic reaction occurs at that 2-to-1 H2S to SO2 ratio. It's an exothermic reaction, meaning heat is released, so we should see a temperature rise across the catalyst bed. Fully active catalyst will allow for equilibrium of the Claus reaction to be reached. And the Claus reaction is favored at lower temperatures. So we'll talk about that a little bit more. The first converter always runs hotter in order to maximize hydrolysis of COS and CS2, and that means converting these unwanted byproducts back into SO2. So SRE recommends a temperature of 343 degrees Celsius for a full alumina bed and 315 for a full titania catalyst, because the titania is more sensitive. And then if you have a mixed bed, it could be anywhere between there, like maybe 325 or 330. Downstream converters run cooler to maximize the Claus reaction. This means operating 10 degrees centigrade above the sulfur dewpoint temperature, which is typically somewhere between 160 and 200 degrees Celsius. There's a picture of some nice brand new Claus catalyst. Hasn't been affected by any deactivation mechanisms yet. So there's a number of mechanisms that can cause catalyst deactivation. They include BTEX and methanol poisoning, sulfation, hydrothermal aging, normal aging, and sooting. BTEX poisoning occurs when the RF is unable to completely destroy the BTEX compounds in the acid gas feed stream. The resulting effect is a cracking or polymerizing of these components onto the Claus catalyst. Methanol poisoning is normally due to an SRU with an acid gas bypass, which allows the methanol to bypass the RF. And both these poisoning deactivation mechanisms are permanent, non-reversible. And then sulfation of the catalyst occurs when excessive free oxygen is carried over from either the reaction furnace or direct fired reheaters. Hydrothermal aging results when the catalyst is exposed to excessive amounts of water vapor over a long period of time. And this could be due to a serious tube or tube sheet leak from the waste heat boiler or condensers. But the actual physical mechanism is still not completely understood with this hydrothermal aging. And thermal aging is caused by thermal excursions or sulfur fires in the catalyst beds. Temperatures above 1300 degrees Fahrenheit, which are all too easy to obtain during a serious sulfur fire, can result in fusing of the catalyst into large solid pieces. Soot deposition and liquid sulfur deposition on top of the catalyst results in plugging of the converter beds. These aren't technically deactivation mechanisms, but they are very problematic because they do plug it up and lower your activity. So optimizing the converters means taking measures to prevent these catalyst deactivation mechanisms from occurring. To prevent poisoning, we have to clean up the feed streams and ensure the reaction furnace temperature is adequate for maximum destruction of contaminants. To prevent sulfation and carbon fouling, we have to optimize the burn strategies or burn ratios for the RF and any DFRs that may be in place. This minimizes the free oxygen carryover and prevents soot deposition. Then, to prolong the aging and general attrition of the catalyst, we have to optimize the temperature controls and keep up with the maintenance and calibrations. Following the proper startup and shutdown procedure is also key, because that's what really speeds up the general attrition and aging, is any abrupt temperature changes. And all it takes is one poor startup or shutdown and you can completely deactivate the catalyst.